McDonald's old stones, their like ancient crosses.
Oh. Hello.
I've got a feeling that you're definitely going to get wet and muddy.
They can make 250
quid if
you fall on your face.
Why?
We do,
because we're bringing up the rear. It's been very quiet, Joe, I thought, really. Keeping his own counsel.
A pilgrimage.
It does rather, but you can see the cross, can't you?
Yeah.
No.
The carved cross.
In the middle stone.
The little stone towards the top there.
A big stone.
Right there.
Oh yeah.
You see it?
No.
Right there.
There's one on here as well, on the smaller.
Yeah, see that one.
So this is an ancient place of meeting to spread the word.
Marked with crosses. Commemorate.
The roundhouse, yeah, that was originally the Celtic roundhouse that was taken over and reused by the Vikings.
It's a couple of hundred years, it's like been a middle name, you know, but it's been handed down, you know.
My mother's middle name was
Kazanak,
which was a handed down one.
Not
Sassanak? No, not Sassanak.
Dividing the fields up into braids.
All right.
So
well, that makes sense, doesn't it?
A braid of cabbages.
Yeah.
A braid of cauliflowers. A braid of something else.
Well, that makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? If this was a settlement, then which it was.
Braid. Bread.
Across there, that's St Patrick's Isle. Probably go there tomorrow. Thank you. imagine what the UK was like.
Yeah. I can't live in these kind of places.
I just think
they're very beautiful
and small. I think I could. As long as there was enough to do, you know.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that's my problem. It just has to be placed.
Yes. So that's your first keel chapel. Well, Northumberland. The profusion of celandine.
Yes.
Oh, I found some amazing ones. Yeah. Children are collecting them.
Yeah, religious structures on that.
Up for
your next trip.
Well, these lot are. Well, they should. There's too many of them though. I'll have to get hire another minibus. Sorry, what was that?
What are your earrings?
Are we going by boat?
Yeah. Meet you around in Peel.
Are you front or back?
I'll drive.
around it.
So that's the track down to the Keel Chapel, which is down there, which is the Hermitage, and here is Spooty Vane. Well, Julia. But I think his actual hermitage that he built was in this corner. So did you come up here last time you were?
No.
You didn't come up this bit?
I was telling absolute lies.
Ah! Okay. You have to go back to church again now. More orchids.
Sandwiches.
Correct.
Exactly. I can have
Mum is 9:20. Corned beef hash and a cappuccino. Fantastic, isn't it? I love these really early ones where they've just got like
basic really have any crosses. Look at the stuff on that there.
Really it's really quite, it's quite intricate, isn't it?
It's probably very equal on either side.
Yeah, absolutely. And that one there with the
that must be ancient.
Kind of the flowery. Yeah. What would you call that? The shape on the top?
Cross, but it's done like, you know, the red cross.
It's like a very basic early cross, that one, yeah.
It's like a first aid cross.
Some of these would have been just outside all the old keel churches.
Yeah.
It's fantastic, this one. That's like the one at the Lonan Church where you were talking about. The one at Lonan Church is kind of just at a little angle for some reason.
I like the ones on Iona, they're beautiful. We're way later.
Yeah. See, one of the original keel chapels. Yeah, there was a few, there's still three left. But there used to be quite a few here.
This is
the one with the well.
You have to do like two for one specials or something to get people to come to theirs rather than
one to talk
about poltergeists before.
Poltergeists? No joke.
Mention the word. No.
No, they've never mentioned it.
No.
Sorry.
I
don't think so. Right, so the other one.
Yes.
Is down. There. See that? I know, why that particular word? Exactly what I thought, but it's
how stupid. Oh dear me. He'll be taken in his grave.
Well, only Morris is in that. I'm sure that's not. I don't think that is done. There you go, this is the old parish cross.
Oh, that's amazing.
Isn't it? Now we're in that stuff that they keep outside.
What, the mud or the nature?
Nature. What's that stuff they keep outside?
Nature.
Well, let's do it. Let's get up there. Down the passageway.
Okay, off we go. Does it happen? It's
200 metres.
Not so bad, really. Right, after the first old video, halfway there. Where's Uncle Joe? Here he is, Uncle Joe Bimbles. I like the way the tree grows along the outside of the building.
It's
like a new age
album cover.
It just needs to be
It's not much age album. It's doing to it, just
needs
destroying inside and
then
the roof
putting
on it.
You think it's a bit of a
do-rupper? Oh, absolutely, definitely. It'll
need a damp cover.
Yeah, well, if nobody's going to live in it, then it would be lovely. Like, you know those shielings that you get you know, when you're walking a long way and you can just have them overnight and it's just like a bear house, isn't it? They could just have it as a...
Is that like a house of birds? That bit over there is the ritual ceremonial area. This bit that you're in here, in this sort of semicircle, and then the chambered tomb, the chambered curtains are behind, and that would have been covered over with a huge mound. And there was a Bronze Age burial rat at the end. Came much later, because this is more Neolithic. Piece of quartz over the top of kind of the entrance there.
Why do they have these at the entrance
here? I know it is, isn't it?
Like no one has the answer.
There must be a reason for it. I mean, he must have had... got you!
Now, why do you think they've got quartz over the entrance?
Why have they got quartz over the entrance? Well, I'll tell you, Debbie.
Yes?
Why do you think they got quartz over the entrance?
I think it's to do with magic.
Magic, okay.
Why do you think?
I think it's because to do with magic, mate. I think it's to do with magic.
Magic! Monkey magic!
Yeah.
I'm even going to zoom in onto that bit of quartz.
I've already done it.
Oh, I have as well. Hey, it's good, isn't it?
Fantastic, isn't it?
There's a lot of spirals. The Incas did a lot on the stonework.
Yeah, they have them in Malta as well.
Yeah.
There's some in the lake.
Image somewhere.
There are some in the Lake District on Long Meg, Little Meg, and Glastonbury stone circles as well. That's it, Lady Elizabeth, as Isabella.
I think engineering's the most interesting thing, really.
Yeah. Massive, massive tomb. Well, it's bigger than Castellinard, really, isn't it?
This not is been the.
That's the one we just went to.
Oh, sorry. I thought you were talking about somewhere in Wales.
This is.
I didn't go into that, did I? So I didn't know. I only got half a story from that.
We would have started off from there and gone off up past the wall. Over to the other side of the road.
Yeah, I definitely think that.
They've got the entrance port there, but they've not got any crystal there. Any quartz. You've got a very well defined.
Oh yeah, that chamber there.
Yeah, that's the same. You remember when you looked
yeah,
into
it is, isn't it?
Same sort of idea. And you can see past it at the other side, you can see the where the different chambers went off. So that's the first chamber, and the second chamber is just made into a, it's been cut across, hasn't it, by the wall, unfortunately.
The other side's quite flally. It's kind of excellent.
Well, that's the haven't, you see, and that's the big problem. I don't see how they can now.
No, I mean, it's not. I'm assuming that it's fairly important that people can get from. It's not like a detour.
Over there, it's like another ritual end. So that makes me think that it was another chambered tomb, a separate one that was actually facing the other one. Because you don't get chambered tombs with a ritual end, a ritual area at both ends.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
So they're kind of end to end with a little gap in between them.
Well, I think so, but some people say they're joined up. But I don't see how it can be if there's a ritual area at both ends. It makes no sense. This is definitely the right one.
There's another cut down there in the gravestone.
Yes. And this here, this window, what does it show? It's got the King of Man. It's got the
Viking boat.
The Bishop of Sodor and Man. What's the bottom one?
The local Bishop.
Yeah. The King of Man and the Isles and the Bishop of Sodor and Man.
Yeah, it just makes you feel a bit dizzy.
It's actually quite a nice place to take a picture because there's all the flowers around it.
It's fantastic,
yeah,
isn't it? Yeah, I love it.
Have you got the flowers?
That's my favourite cross.
And we found it straight away, we went, wow.
Look at that one.
Basket weaving.
It's like cable knitting, isn't it?
Yeah. My basket weaving.
Alan's sweater.
It's really so intricately done, isn't it? Really.